Okobojo is another town that once bustled with business and family. A few houses remain and a cemetery on private land off the beaten path that few even know exist.
I call such places mere ghost towns because they are a shell of their former selves. They once maybe had 150 people or 200, and now they're down to maybe 50, maybe 25 people, maybe 6. It's what's happened to them as a community. They've lost their identity. But as long as someone lives there, I think that they still have a sense of worth as a community.
Patricia Harding grew up in what was Okobojo. Even though there is not much there today, her memories of this small farming community are still vivid.
We moved there about when I was in the fifth grade. Actually, it was a little town. There was a store there, there was a telephone office, and then there were several houses in that area. Oh, I loved it there. You know, we just roamed around, and we could walk across the bridge and up to the hall. There were dances up at the hall, and we'd go to those dances, our parents, and the kids would dance right along with the parents.
It was created about 1883, and it was a small village. It, for many years, had a big general store and a school and a big dance hall. But earlier on, as I said, it had this newspaper, it had the Bank of Okobojo, it had a couple of other stores. It was kind of a boom town in a sense. The plan was to sell lots, which they did, but here again they were waiting for the ill-fated railroad, which never arrived, thus sealed its doom in a sense.
There is absolutely nothing there. It was just a little community there that it was wonderful, wonderful place. And I'm sure there are a lot of other towns around South Dakota that the same thing happened to.